Hi, I'm Lisa Sears, no relation to this door. And well, I can't get into the tower though, so if you go up there to Chicago, just tell them that you know me and they'll let you in for free. Don't tell them they let everybody in for free. So all my life, I thought the worst word you could say was the C word. Right? You know? Do you win? Oh, not that one. That's later. But I've come to find out it's actually not even the worst word. There's one way worse. And it is so bad it makes people cringe. I mean, it makes people cringe more than when they have a thought of, like, let's say the president grabbing their pussy. Moist. I mean, people flip shit for that word. You say moist and they're like, whoa. I mean, it's not that bad of a word. I looked it up. The definition of moist is slightly wet, damp, or humid. I'm not sure what's wrong with that. I mean, a lot of things we like to eat, we like moist. Right? Like our Thanksgiving turkey, a nice piece of cake, or fish tacos. All right, I know what you guys are probably thinking, that I look like a lesbian. You would be right. So, but you guys realize they made gay marriage legal about 3 years ago this week, right? Right? Gives me something to do because I'm an ordained minister and I actually officiate many homotastic weddings. Some breeders too, because I'm not racist. But the problem with gays is they don't realize just because it's legal, that doesn't mean they should, you know? Just because you can doesn't mean you should. Kind of like leggings. It's over a medium, no. And now that company, LuLaRue, what is it? What's that? LuLaRue? Something like that? You know what I'm talking about, right? They're making it worse because they come in every color and design. Yeah, no, not over a medium. But Sears, it's a unicorn. That looks like a rhino. Sears. All right, turn around. You're right, it's not a rhino. That's a camel, I see its foot. And you know what? That's probably going to be the number one gift given at Christmas this year because that's all the rage, the leggings and stuff, LuLaRue. Did you guys realize, though, that Christmas is like only 180 days away? Mm-hmm. We're halfway there. What's your favorite holiday?
Christmas.
Okay. Favorite holiday?
Halloween.
What's yours?
Thanksgiving.
Okay, good. Mine's Christmas, too, you know, and we're halfway there, so I'm kind of excited about it. And you guys probably all have those Christmases from when you were younger that you remember that just stand out in your mind. One of mine was this one year, my mom, you know, I was all excited and opening my presents. She goes, I think I heard Santa down in the basement. So, of course, I run downstairs, and there was the Muppet drum set that I wanted so bad. I'm like, yes. Santa was smart enough, though, to put it in the basement so I didn't drive my parents nuts, right? But a couple years later, that's one of the two that I remember the most from when I was young, like under seven or so. The other one was I heard a ruckus out in the driveway before I'd gotten up on Christmas morning. And I jump up and I look out the window of my bedroom and there's a convertible Cadillac out there with a bow on it. And I'm like, holy shit, Santa brought me a car. Yeah, he's pretty badass. And then I remember I'm not old enough to even drive a moped, let alone drive a car. So I'm like, okay, it must be for my mom. And it was for my mother, and this car was amazing. I didn't get the benefits from it though, but you know, it was very nice. I was kind of jealous of her. But the next year I wasn't as jealous of her because you know what Santa got her the next year? The book of payments for that car because he ran off with the dirty elf from down the street. There are no elves, in case you didn't know. So a few years ago, he said cancer, so I'm going to bring that up. A few years ago, I had a little case of breast cancer, and I say little because they were pretty little. So, hey, but I had to go to the girly doctor because they wanted to check me for other cancers, and I had to get examined, and she pulls out this wand. And I'm like, and then she puts a condom on it. And I'm like, how am I supposed to wear that? It doesn't have straps. I listen to serious, that's my time.